Monkeypox has been around for years, and it was really causes a rash that's similar to smallpox. And so with the elimination of smallpox in the early 70s is when monkeypox was discovered. So it starts off with fever and then general body aches, malaise, muscle aches, similar to influenza. That usually precedes the development of the rash. And if people have looked online and seen the rash, it starts off as a macule, a flat raised lesion, but then it forms a firm nodule that's really hard to miss. From there, it develops into more of a blister and then a pustule, and then it scabs over. Generally, the transmission occurs due to prolonged skin-to-skin contact, or it may occur with respiratory contact, but these are large respiratory droplets that don't travel far. So the CDC considers you being at risk if you're with somebody who's infectious within 6 feet of them for 3 hours or more. And I think that goes to show you how much less infectious that is compared to something like COVID. People may be infectious as soon as the prodrome starts, the fever and the not feeling well, and then they stay infectious throughout the rash until the skin is healed over. You know, the smallpox vaccine has some cross protection against monkeypox, so it is being made available through public health for people who've had contact with confirmed or suspected cases of monkeypox. If it's given within 4 days of exposure, it protects about 85% of the time. But even if it's given after 4 days of exposure, if it's given up to 2 weeks after exposure, it may modify its disease, making it less severe. Monkeypox, generally, people who have it, they generally recover on their own. But about 5% of people who have monkeypox may die. The current strain, however, causes less severe disease and is expected to have a mortality rate of about 1%. Treatment is generally supportive, but there are some antiviral treatments that are available, as well as immune globulin that's available. If people have had suspected exposure to somebody with monkeypox to a confirmed or suspected cases, and it's a significant exposure, then contact your healthcare provider, because then they can refer you to potentially get vaccinated to prevent infection.